Yeah, welcome to Akuma Solutions. In our previous video, we talked about definition of limits as far as healing is concerned. And we took an example, right? So we want to look at another example. Right, so let's see, we want to evaluate the limit of. So you look at this function and you will tell me the type of function it is. But if you will be successful in doing that, if you have watched the previous video on the basic definitions. So I hope you able to see that this is actually the greatest integer function. Okay. So we are evaluating the limits of this. So we want to find this. And let's see how we do that. Solution. So we have the limit of so to do this particular thing, we need to find out whether the right limit is there and the left limit is also there. So when the right limit equals the left limit, then we can conclude that the limit of this particular function is equal to that one. So let's add that. So we start by looking at the limit of this function as x approaches 2. So we are picking it from the right. So as x approaches 2 from the right, then so according to Henning, I'm going to say that for all xn, so xn approaching 2, so we are getting closer to 2, then fn here is greater than 2 because we are approaching 2 from the right. Okay. But what we want to do is to try and create the smallest interval within which this so this function, which will soon turn into a sequence, will converge in that small interval. So to get the smallest interval, we want to close this ring so that xn is that value which is between 2 and what? 3. Okay. And if all of this is in place, then the implication is that we now going to have, so this changes to this, and divided by 2, and then what will this be? So we have this one here. And minus, okay. By definition, what we have here is that we're looking for the greatest integer, which is less than or equal to x. Okay, less than or equal to x. Then if you come here, you have xn divided by 2. It means you need to create that condition. So we'll come here and divide each of the terms by 2. We have 3 n divided by 2, should be greater than xn divided by 2, and then should be greater than 2 divided by 2, which of yours will be giving us what? 1. So this is just 1. Okay, so back to this place, we are looking for the greatest integer, which is less than or equal to xn. So we'll come to the interval we have created here. So when we come here, for instance, we are looking for the greatest integer which is less than or equal to xn. So we come here, we realize that xn is greater than or equal to what? 2. Then we have 3 here, which is greater than, or so we have this one being greater than, 3 greater than or xn. So we have xn to be greater than 2. It means that 2 is less than xn. But here by definition we say that we are looking for the greatest integer which is less than or equal to xn. So if xn is greater than 2, then it means that 2 here is less than xn. So it means that by definition we are satisfying what is it? So it's appropriate that we put this place equal to 2. So the greatest integer which is less than xn, as far as the domain or the interval you have created here is concerned, it's going to be 2. Now let's move on and see what happens. So at this point, you're also looking for the greatest integer, which is less than or equal to xn over 2. So come here, this is xn over 2. The xn over 2 is greater than 1, which means that 1 is less than xn over 2. So in this aspect, we also realize that the greatest integer, which is less than xn over 2, is going to go 1. So we place 1 here, and the result gives us what? So this is the limit to the right. So you can say the right hand limit. Right hand limit. Now let's check the left hand limit and see. So we have the left hand limit. So it means we are looking at the limits of this function. Okay. So as s approaches 2 from the left. So what we mean is that according to n, then we will be having for all xn, we want to state that when xn is getting closer to 2, then xn is going to be less than 2 because we are approaching 2 from the left. We will not get at to 2 exactly, we will be less than 2. But just as in the first case, we're trying to create the smallest interval in which this sequence is going to converge. And we want to close this one in 1 so that Sn is now between 1 and 2. Okay. Now, because of the presence of x over 2, we want to divide each of the terms in this interval by 2 so that we have 1 over 2, which is less than xn over 2, which is less than, so if you divide this place by 2, then you get in with 1. Now, when all this is in place, then the implication is that we're going to have xn, so that's the greatest integer function of this, then minus xn over 2. Yeah, good. So here, we are looking for the greatest integer, which is less than or equal to xn. So we come to the related interval. Come here. So what is there? So that 1 is less than xn. The xn is less than 2, which means that 2 is greater than xn, which is not satisfying the condition. It's saying that greatest is there, which is less than or equal to xn. But 1 here is less than xn. So it's appropriate that we say what we have here is equal to 1. Then minus. So one, we are looking for the greatest integer, which is less than or equal to xn over 2. But when we come here, we realize that this is 0.5 or half. And it's also less than xn over 2. So we are tempted to say that the greatest integer, which is less than or equal to xn over 2, is half. But we realize that 0.5 is not an integer. So if we are looking for the, so you have something like this, 0.5, then the greatest is less than or equal to 0.5, will be what? 0. So on that basis, you have this place of 0, and at the end, you see that you are getting the answer to what? 1. So here, we have shown that the right hand limit here is giving us 1, and the left side limit or the left hand limit is also giving us 1. So you can say that since the left hand limit equals the right hand limit, okay, then the limit of so we have the function here is divided by 2 as x approaches 2 is equal to 1. Good. So that is our second example. I hope you found this one very useful. Okay. Thanks very much for watching this. I'll meet you again to look at more examples. Thank you very much.